टिप्पी हेलमेट की एक्सचेंज एटलीस्ट दिस एल्गोरिथम इज यूज्ड फॉर एक्सचेंजिंग द कीज इनेबल सपोज देयर आर इट इनेबल टू यूजर फॉर सिक्योरली एक्सचेंज ए की दैट मींस बाय यूजिंग दिस टू यूजर कैन सिक्योरली एक्सचेंज द एक्सचेंज देयर सीक्रेट कीज सो व्हाट इज इन दैट एल्गोरिथम आई विल शो यू एग्जांपल आफ्टरवर्ड इज प्रिमिटिव रूट ऑफ A is a primitive root of prime number P. Suppose there is a prime number that is P, then A is primitive root of prime number P, whose power modulo P generates all integer value from 1 to P minus 1. If we take power modulo of P, then it will generate the integer value from 1 to P minus 1. Okay, so I am saying that A is a primitive root whose value is always from 1 to P minus 1. A is a primitive root whose value is always from P 1 to P minus 1. Now, suppose these are the values which it will contain. A mod P, A square mod P, A P minus 1 mod P. So, what is here? A is a primitive root. We are taking mod of P. P is a prime number. And in this case, we are squaring the A square mod P. That is second number. Like this we will do till it is AP minus 1 mod P. So here, what is, now I am taking A and B are primitive root of A. A and B are primitive root of A of prime number P. Unique exponent I such that I will take this B is equal to A. What are B and A? B are primitive root of A. A and B are primitive root of P and we are taking power of that and we are mod with P. That is I value will be between 0 and I is a integer value which will be from 0 to P minus 1. That means power is a discrete logarithmic of B for value of A mod P and I value will be always between 0 and P minus 1. So I want to say that this is the algorithm actually. This is the algorithm. In algorithm, I am saying that Q is a prime number. Suppose in our algorithm, what I am using? I am using Q as a prime number. A and B are users which want to exchange their keys. X value is private value. Y value is public value to each side. X value is private value. A and B are users. Q is a prime number. Suppose Q is a prime number. A, B are users. X values are kept private. By values are available public to each other. That means each if both user want to communicate, they will use by as a public value. So these are global variables and keys generation. How to generate the key? Now suppose Q is a prime number, A and B user want to generate their keys and X are their private key and Y are their public key. So I am saying that suppose X say they are choosing a key that is less than Q. They are trying to choose the key that is less than prime number. Suppose A want to choose their key. In that case, A will select any random number. That will be less than a prime number Q. And they will able to compute the public value, they will able to complete. See, x is a private value, which is a random number, which is less than a prime number, and they will compute the public value by using this x. Say, how they will compute? A user will compute its public key by using by A. That means A user is computing its public key by A is equal to alpha. What is alpha? There we have taken A, here we are taking alpha. Alpha is a integer that is primitive root of Q. Alpha is a integer which is primitive root of Q. So, in when we want to find out by A, we will take primitive root of Q, and we will that A user will use its private key which is selected by A user, any random integer. So it will use any random integer as a power of primitive root and mod Q. Q is a prime number. In the similar way, user B will generate its key. It will choose a user B will choose a private number in the random integer value less than Q and compute its public key by using alpha is a primitive root of Q, alpha rise to the power of X B. That means private key of B. Mod Q. So in this way, they will compute, user A will compute its public key and user B will compute its public key. And user A compute key, that means it has computed one key, from that it will compute a secret key. From that it will compute a secret key. Suppose user A want to compute a secret key, how it will get a secret key? It will use its secret key by using the secret number which is used by this A. They will use secret number which was used by this XA. How they will compute? At least two students are more there, so I have joined. They were in waiting. So I am saying that how user A will compute its secret key? It will compute its secret key by using this random integer which A have chosen, and it will use the public key which was made by user B and a prime number. That means if A user want to make its secret key, it will use the public key which is provided by B user by B. It will use public key provided by user, B user, which is by B, and it will rise it to random number which A has chosen. A want to create a secret key. So it will use the random number chosen by A, that is XA, and mode of key, that is secret key of user A. In the similar fashion, user B will also create a secret key. How it will create this secret key? User B will create a secret key by using XB and public key of A user. By A rise to XB. And it will perform mod Q operation on that. That means K user will generate its secret key. These are two calculation produce unique result. That means this K which is being produced by both the users are the same. See, XA may be different, XB different, YB and YA are different, that are public keys, XA different, XB are different, XA is only known to the user A, XB is only known to user B, and K is the secret key which is prepared by user A, and this K is secret key prepared by user B. And this K will have the same value. If we perform the calculation, this will result a unique value. Like this, you can see over here k by b xa. That means k by b xa mod 2. suppose I am taking the key of A user, which has generated secret key by A user. Here, what is by B contained? By B is, I am proving that. By B, what is by B here? By B, that is public key known to A user. By B is equal to alpha X key. So I am putting this, instead of this by B, I am putting alpha X key mode 2. And that is rise to XA. So I have rise to XA and mode key. So this can also be written alpha XB into A, XA, rise to XA, mode key I have taken in common by using rule of modular S minus. So mode key I have taken common. In this way, alpha, what is the value of, in this case, I can also write in such a way that XB gone here, XA came here. So I can write alpha XA and mode Q means I have, before I have taken common, now I have separated them again. And XB will come out and mode Q. So in this way, what is the value of this one? This one is public key created by A. So it is by A. This value comes by A and XB came over here, so XB mode 2. Hence, it is proved that if K value is the same for both the users, hence it is proved that K value is same for both the users. Now I am taking, so to determine the private key of user B, adversary means attacker. Attacker must compute XB. To determine the private key of user B, adversary, that means attacker, must compute XB equal to logarithmic function like this. So what is the advantage of this? Advantage of, see, this is the way how to produce the key. And I have just proved this. This is the way to create a secret key. And this is the way to create the public key. And hence I prove that value of K is same for both the users. Value of K is same for both the users. Value of same for both the users. Hence I prove that over here. And what is the advantage of using this? It is easy to calculate. That means it is easy to calculate exponential modulo of a prime number. It is easy to calculate exponential modulo A of prime number. But it is difficult to create discrete logarithmic. In this case, what I have used? I have used discrete logarithmic for this algorithm. So it will be difficult for attacker to attack this system. Otherwise, if key exchange is done by exponential modulo, it is easy to attack. But in this algorithm, I have used, means we have used discrete logarithmic, so it is hard to attack. Or when we will take greater large prime number, this task becomes invisible, means attacking becomes infeasible. What bit example I am taking over here for this prime number is Q. Suppose our prime number is Q, primitive root of 353 is 3, and A and B select a secret key. Suppose A selected its secret key as 97 and B selected its secret key as 233. This is our example. Suppose Q is 353. I am saying that in our example, suppose Q is 353 and primitive root of 353 is, in our case, is 3. It is not shown over here, actually it is 3. Suppose Q is given to us and primitive root we have found out from 353, it is 3. And suppose A has selected the secret key as 97 and B has selected its secret key as 233. Now I want to compute the by A. By A, that means public key of A. Then how A will compute its public key? A will compute its public key by alpha. Alpha is a primitive root of prime number 353 in our case, that is 3. And we will write it with private key of A. Private key secret key, whatever value it is choosing, it is choosing to put 97 as a secret key, that would be less than a prime number 353. So it has chosen 97. And 3 raised to 97 mod Q, that is 353, it got its value as a public key as 14. And B, let me connect one more student. Student is there in the waiting. Now I am saying that in our case, how to choose the that a user have chosen its private key as 97 and primitive root it found of Q is 3. So it has chosen its public key by a alpha xa mod q. Same formula we have used for public key choosing. So I have got the result 14. And we computed its public key by alpha raised to private number which has chosen by B user 233 mod 353, that is equal to 248. That came answer as a 248. So what is the public key of A 40? What is the public key of B 248? And that is being exchanged to user of A and B. That means A will share its public key 40 to user B, and B user will share its public key 242 with user A. So now, after the exchange of public key between the user, user will complete secret key by using same formula I mentioned already. For computing its secret key, A will compute its secret key by using public key which is provided by user B, by B, and a private value which is chosen by user A. Random number, random integer value, that is xa, and mod q, it has performed. So it is 248, key which was provided to user A by user B, that was 248, and it has chosen it xa, the number which is generated by user A, which is less than prime number 353, that is 97, it has chosen and mod 353, it got answer first. So it is the secret key for user A. In the similar way, secret key for user B is by a xb mod 353. That means by a the key public key provided by user A to user B. So it has kept over here, and xb the private value chosen by user B, that is kept here 233 mod 2. So it is its value is also 150. Now it got this value. Now I am saying that now they can use this key and encrypt their message. That means key exchange is done. Now brute force attack may be possible on this. Brute force attack may determine secret key 160. Suppose attacker is having this information. Suppose attacker is having Q value. Attacker is having primitive root of Q, and attacker has found out the public key of A and public key of B. Then attack may be possible by brute force attack. That how it is possible? It is finding the alpha A mod 353, that is 40, or it is finding the 3 raised to B mod 353, that is 248. Now, attacker can calculate 3 modulo 353. That means attacker do not know what is the value of A, attacker do not know what is the value of B. Now attacker has to calculate the value of A and B. How it will calculate? By brute force attack, it will apply all the numbers which is less than 353 to get the private key. So attacker has applied the value using 3 raised to 1 mod 353, 3 raised to 2 mod 353, 3 raised to 3 mod 353. In the similar fashion, it will apply on this also. And once it gets the answer as a 40, that it will think it is a private key. So now attacker has find out one place where it will raise to 397, it will come. Mod 350 value attacker will get 40. That means it will find out that private key of A is 97 by using brute force attack. So how you can how we can neglect the brute force attack? By choosing a very big prime number. That means this was 353, so it got its answer. We should choose a very big prime number. So when we will choose a very big prime number, brute force attack may not be possible. So brute force attack may not be possible. Now what will happen? With large number problem become impractical. That means when we will choose very large number of this and very large number we will get of this all value, then brute force attack may not be possible. And now, so user should keep public key in central directory. That means the user should keep this public key in a central directory. It must not be available to the attacker. Public key. If public key attacker is getting, it is able, see, public key attacker is getting and it is able to find out the private key. It is able to find out the secret key which is given by you. And so that from that it can find out the secret key. So how to do that? By using the public key in a central live directory, we can get authentication and confidentiality. So what is confidentiality? Confidentiality is user A and B can determine the key. No other can read that message. Only user A and B can determine the public key. No other can read that message. That is known as confidentiality. And what is authentication? Recipient A knows only user B could have created a message using key. And no other user is creating the message through this key. This process is known as authentication. So let me join other two participants. Two participants are waiting. Now I am saying that, but this technique do not protect against replay attack. This technique we have used, this technique may not protect against, it can protect against brute force attack, but it may not protect against replay attack. So what is replay attack? That is man in middle attack. What is replay attack? That is man in middle attack. That means a middle person is attacking the network and getting the message from it and diverting that message and sending to user B. That means whatever the message is coming from user A, it is snooping it from the network and it is sending other message, means it is making some modification in that message and sending to user B. In the similar fashion, user, whatever the message is coming from user B, it is making the modification, attacker is making the modification and sending it to user A. So that is known as man in middle attack. So A and B want to exchange the key. Suppose A and B user want to exchange the key and D is the attacker. So D prepare for attack by generating two random private key. That means D want to attack. Whatever the message is sent from A, it want to attack that message, and whatever the message is sent by user B, it want to attack that message. So what D will do? D is the attacker. So D will prepare attack by generating two random private keys. That means D will generate its random private key as D1 and as D2. Okay, it will choose any random number which is less than Q value. And then computing corresponding public key, then it will also calculate the corresponding public key. That means public key can be, if this message is between both the users, that means it is, he is having both the message, both the secret key, XD1 and XD2, they are with them. Actually, it is not you. It is not the secret key of user 1, it is A, or it is not the secret key of user 2. But attacker himself makes taken a random number. And by using that random number, it generated the public key. By using this random number, it generated, attacker generated this public key. And by using this random number, attacker generated. And A transmits by A to B user. Suppose A, now A transmitting its public key to for the user B. Suppose A transmitting its public key to user B. Due to intercept, attacker done the intercept, D attacker done the intercept of by A, and instead of by A, it trans the user A was sending by A public key to user B. But instead of sending by A to user B, interpreter has D as a interceptor has taken the by A value from the network and transmit its own public key by D1 to user B. Instead of by A, what user B got? By D1, the public key of attacker. B user calculated secret key. B user calculated its secret key by using the public key provided by the attack, not the public key provided by the user A. So it uses the public key provided by the user attacker. This is public key provided by the attacker. That is by D1. ठीक है? That means it is the actually secret key prepared by attacker. So attacker will use the value which is given by user A. The attacker will use whatever the value given by user A to user B. It has intercepted the message and it is using that and preparing the secret key. Attacker is preparing this. And it has transmitted its public key to user. Attacker has transmitted its own public key to user. And it has calculated its secret key, whatever the value is transmitted by user A. Now B received by D1. Now user B received the key, public key of attacker, and calculated its secret key by using attacker public key value. Now what happened? B transmit X A to user A. Now B transmit X A to user A. User D intercept this. D user intercept this and transmit by D2. That means it transmitted, now B transmitted its public key, that is intercepted by, something is written I think to know. D user is intercepting, actually D user intercepted the public key provided by user A, by user B to user A is want to send, but it has stolen that. Now user D calculates from the public value which is provided by user B to user A, and it calculated the secret key also, and transmitted its own public value, that is by D1 is transmitted to user B by attacker, and by D2 is provided to the user A by the attacker. User A received by D2 and calculate it. So user A is calculating the its secret key by using the public key value provided by the attacker. At this point, user B and user A think that they share a secret key, but instead of user and B and D, user, that means who actually shared the secret key? यूजर ए सीक्रेट की इज शेयर्ड बाय अटैकर डी एंड यूजर बी सीक्रेट की इज शेयर्ड बाय अटैकर डी एंड इट हैज ट्रांसमिटेड इट्स ऑन की टू यूजर ए एज वेल एज यूजर बी. सो दे विल एनक्रिप्ट इट्स मैसेज बाय यूजिंग द की प्रोवाइडेड बाय अटैकर. सो दिस की एक्सचेंज प्रोटोकॉल इज वल्नरेबल टू सच एन अटैक because it does not authenticate the participants. That means no authentication is done for the participant, whether it, the public key came from the attacker or public key came from the real user. So no authentication is done for this. That is why this attack is possible. Middleman attack is possible. That is replay attack. This depends. Deficiency can overcome by using digital signature and public key certificate. This deficiency can be avoided by using digital signature and public key certificate. So I think so. Today class is over now. Now I'm going to stop recording.